Okay, guys, let's say you need a military-grade drone that can take off and land vertically. Now, there are hundreds of such drones all over the world, right? I mean, they're very ubiquitous. They're available in every country. They're usually made in China. I mean, you even see little children and grandmas fly them around as toys for fun. So, yes, they're fun to fly, but they tend to be kind of small and flimsy. You can't really fly them if there's any kind of strong wind at all because they get blown away. You can't really attach anything heavy to them. If you fly them for like 15 minutes and then you have to change the battery if you want to keep on flying them. And they're just not very economical. So, what if you need a drone that can stay airborne for up to 6 hours? 6 hours nonstop. Okay, what if you need a drone that can climb to 18,000 feet, which is at the level of most clouds, right? It's a little over 5,000 meters, 18,000 feet. What if you need a drone that can do both of those things, plus carry a 5 kilogram payload, a 5 kilo payload, which is 11 pounds for our American friends? Well, given those criteria, now you've really narrowed down your choices to maybe only a handful of drones worldwide. Right, there aren't a lot of companies that produce drones with these capabilities, especially given the capability to take off and land vertically. Now, one such company is called Uavera from Ankara, Turkey, and they produce a drone called Cagatay CGT50. Okay, it's Cagatay CGT50. Guys, I came across this drone while surfing the web for random footage of UAVs, of drones, and I was just freaking blown away by this drone's capabilities. It's just the most freaking awesome drone design that I've ever seen in my life, and I'm just so excited to tell you all about it. So, there are generally two types of aircraft, right? One, you've got your regular winged aircraft, like a regular passenger airplane. Now, this aircraft design has the advantage of being able to travel very long distances, right? I mean, you can take the passenger airplane from San Francisco to Tokyo, and you know it would be like a 18-hour, 20-hour flight, but you'd get there. It's a long distance travel. And then two, you've got your like rotary wing aircraft, like a helicopter. Now, helicopters generally cannot travel very long distances, but they happen to have the unique advantage of being able to take off and land wherever they like because they've got that vertical rotor, that big propeller, which allows the helicopter to be able to take off and land wherever it likes. All you need is some flat surface for the helicopter to be able to fit in. Now, this UAV, CGT-50, by Uavera Systems, Aviation Systems, combines both of those aviation principles on the same drone. So, how does this drone achieve that? Now, CGT-50 starts its flight vertically using 4 electric motors. So, just like your everyday toy drone, just your regular electric motors that you would commonly see on a regular toy drone. It climbs and climbs, and then once it reaches a certain safe altitude, it switches on its gas engine and starts gliding just like a regular winged airplane. Yeah, that's right. It's got a 100cc gasoline engine in the front that instantly turns the drone into a winged airplane, which is really, really cool. So what does this achieve exactly? Well, a few things. First, it increases the velocity to a cruise speed of 48 knots, which is a fancy way to say about 88 kilometers per hour. Second, it increases the flight endurance to 6 hours, like I mentioned earlier. Now, do you know how many batteries you would like otherwise need to keep your like tow drone airborne for 6 hours? Oh my God, like a lot, maybe hundreds of them. Now, what would you need a drone like this for? Well, I guess sky's the limit, right? The cliche answer. A drone capable of vertical takeoff and landing with such long flight endurance and high payload capability really solves a lot of problems. First of all, because it's a vertical takeoff and landing aircraft, you really don't need a runway, right? I mean, with like a regular winged airplane, you would need a runway to be able to reach a certain speed, a certain airflow over your wings to be able to achieve lift, enough lift to for the aircraft to be able to take off from that runway. With the CGT50, you don't need a runway because it's got those four vertical takeoff electric motors. Now, with the CGT50, you also don't need a catapult system to launch it into the air. Again, that's because you have those four electric motors that gives it enough lift and enough movement to be able to achieve flights by turning on its gasoline engine. So CGT50 can be deployed pretty much anywhere you want, wherever you like, including from ships at sea, like naval ships, or like on top of even mountains, you know. It can be controlled via direct line of sight from a ground station, or it can be controlled via an active satellite link. From a ground station, it has a range of about 150 kilometers. With satellite control, the range is pretty much global. It is only limited by the drone's own flight characteristics. CGT50's maximum takeoff weight is 55 kilos, including a 5 kilo payload, like I mentioned. But its manufacturer, Uavera, is currently working on a version that can carry a 10 kilogram payload. So they're trying to double the payload capacity from 5 kilos to 10 kilos. I'm guessing by maybe adding a more powerful engine and more fuel. I have to mention that the CGT50 is not currently an armed drone. It doesn't carry any weapons at this time. It is for it's not really for military applications at this time, at least not for strike missions. However, it is an excellent drone for surveillance and intelligence gathering operations with unique features that combine tactical vertical takeoff and landing with an HD zoom camera and software features that allow the user to track objects on the move. It read GPS coordinates, calculates speed and direction of targets, and of course more. CGT-50s are used by Turkish forces as observation and recon platforms, as well as for border and coastal monitoring. They make excellent patrol vehicles for remote military bases and police stations. In fact, in Turkey, police use them for routine traffic surveillance at checkpoints in remote places. Now, let's talk a little bit about the company that produces the CGT50. Now, like I said, it's called Overa, like I mentioned earlier. It's not as well known as some of Turkey's other drone manufacturers like Baykar and TUSAS and or Vestel, but given their products, it's obvious that they have an exceedingly innovative team that can think outside the box and solve new problems instead of reinventing the wheel over and over again. So this team at Alvera, apparently they said, "Oh, you know what? We need a new drone with these new capabilities that can, you know, take off and land vertically, but you know, a drone that can also fly long distances." And then somebody came up with a new light bulb and had a light bulb moment, and they came up with this awesome new design. Now, Alvera was first established in 2014 as İvme, Unmanned Aviation Systems, out of Hacettepe Teknokent. But later in 2017, they moved to Ankara Teknokent. And in 2020, they joined the George Kuno's group, George Kuno's group, and they changed their name to Alvera. CGT50 isn't the company's only product, by the way. Alvera makes several different types of UAVs. They also make drone avionics, as well as ground control, communication, and launch systems for some of their other products, like target drones and things like that. And that's pretty much it, guys. I'm going to include the website and contact information of the company of Aware Systems, and so that you can go to their website and check out this awesome design and some of their other products, and be impressed for yourselves. Thank you for tuning in, and I'll catch you guys next time.